Tonight, one Howard County family is racing to raise money for the new Johns Hopkins Children's Center.
And they've recruited 65 runners to take part in the Baltimore Marathon in honor of their baby, who died just 3 days after she was born. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh has their story.
All right, you ready? Ready to run.
Julia and JJ Abel lead the charge around their Ellicott City neighborhood.
Good job, Jay. We're going to be ready for that run.
They're running for the little sister they never got to meet.
This is kind of part of the grieving process. The pink shirts, the awareness, the running.
Jason and Amy Abel organized a team to run the Baltimore Marathon in honor of their third child. Sadie Elizabeth Abel arrived on December 17th, 2006, 2 weeks early.
She was really teeny tiny. That's one of my neatest memories was, you know, the doctor saying, oh, she is a peanut.
And at just 4 pounds, 15 ounces, Sadie appeared healthy.
I guess we took it for granted, which we've learned that lesson, that we shouldn't take anything for granted anymore.
The Abels soon learned that Sadie contracted a strep B infection during birth that was taxing her tiny heart and lungs.
We kind of very quickly went from parents of a newborn healthy child to parents of a child that is very sick and may even die.
The baby was transferred to the PICU at the Johns Hopkins Children's Center and put on a heart and lung bypass machine. As Sadie's condition slipped, Jason and Amy realized they would never bring their daughter home.
I imagined a really beautiful moment holding my baby and that I really felt like I never got. And by the time I held her, I remember looking at Jason and just saying, she's not here.
As much as we don't really like it or we really don't understand it, the plan was for her to come and be here for 3 days and die.
The Abels returned home on December 19th to face Christmas without Sadie. Amy remembers receiving an outpouring of sympathy from friends.
But it was so difficult for us to see all that money going to flowers that we couldn't even keep around the house. So we, at that point, said, well, it at least has to go back to the PICU.
The grieving parents thought back to the cramped consultation room where they received so much sad news about their baby. They decided to dedicate a room in her honor at the new Johns Hopkins Children's Center.
Construction began on the new children's tower months before Sadie passed away. It's expected to open in early 2011. However, her parents are determined to raise the $100,000 they need by the end of this year.
I can't run so long.
65 runners are signed up to run the marathon in Sadie's honor. Team Sadie's Gift has raised $70,000 to date.
If it can be somewhat comforting to families that come after us in our experience, then Sadie's Gift, that gift will be realized.
And the Abels will have an enduring tribute to their little girl, who was only here long enough to leave behind a single set of footprints. In Ellicott City, Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.